Should have added many more lanes, apparently.
Yeah, we screwed up.
Yep. I think I would just go to 5. I think our deck's good and get a good hand.
Okay. I mean, this hand is bad. We have creature enchantments at a creature we can't cast or enchant.
Yeah, we have a creature that can't attack. Alright, whatever.
Yeah, I mean, I've seen better, but...
Seen better.
This draw is fine for 5.
Definitely kept worse 7s.
I'm pretty sure I would just take it if someone was like, here's your 5, do you want a new one? If I could mulligan a 5, I'd probably just keep it. Maybe that's bad. Maybe you should just try to mulligan to any hand with, like, the Phalanx Leader, but...
I mean, this is...
I guess I have to play Pegasus here.
Yeah, we should probably play Pegasus. It's like more devastating to gain save something later anyway.
Yeah, I mean, I was actually thinking about exactly divination, but whatever.
Right, so did I. I don't know if it's right to even count. Like, obviously we would if our mana was untapped.
Are yeah, yeah. Excited about it? No, the thing is, now he plays Coastland Chimera, we're dead.
We're just dead?
Yeah.
So if he plays Coastland Chimera, just attack in...
It only prevents one.
Oh, it only prevents one. Okay, so then we're dead.
Yeah. Omen Speaker, we're basically dead too,
we're
but...
still also dead.
Yeah. Maybe I'll draw, like, an ordeal. That's actually...
Now we can maybe get him.
I guess I just attack with both.
Yeah, we're certainly attacking.
And hope he doesn't double block.
He's probably not going to double block.
He probably will double block. Okay, so now I can just do 2 to him. Is that... because I can't kill the Omen Speaker.
Right.
So. Choose creature prevent damage to. Elite Skirmisher. Choose target to deal damage to the hand.
Hopefully he just taps out for like a psychic invasion or something. Psychic intrusion, whatever that card is.
Yeah, we're not in good shape.
I know.
I really would like to draw Chosen by Heliod.
Well. Nice to gain say that, but...
Aggressive, but...
Could just draw a 100-handed one and be like...
Yeah.
That's good.
That's not bad.
It's 2/4, right?
Yeah.
Alright.
Can't attack. It's tricky if he just plays like a 2/2, I mean.
Yeah, but then we're drawing into, you know, any number of chosen balls.
Yep.
You just need to activate it once or whatever. Sneak.
It's fine. Ooh, okay, that's
nice.
A good draw.
So, this we is, put it on the Worshipper?
This is interesting, I think. Mm. If we put it on the Skirmisher, he takes 5.
Yeah.
I think it's just on the Worshipper.
It has to be the Worshipper, right?
Well, the thing is, let's suppose he has Sip in his hand.
Okay.
We put it on the Skirmisher, we still get to attack once. I think we should put it on the Skirmisher, tap the Disciple, and attack with everything.
So then he sips and we get
So then he sips and at least we get to activate the Worshipper.
Okay, that seems right.
Or if he has some removal spell. The problem is if he has like a cure or something.
Just a cure?
Yeah.
Well, he probably boarded in whatever
The
he
thing
had.
Is, let's suppose he has nothing. We're not that much worse off if we put it on the Skirmisher. We just need to... we're going to scry into any cantrip, any enchantment anyway, right?
Okay. Certain scrying is valuable. Fine draw.
Oh, that's that made no sense. Oh yeah, no, yeah, it did.
It's unblockable, but
yeah, yeah. For a split second, yeah, never mind.
It's got more text.
No. I was thinking for a split second that was like for whatever reason I just brain farted. I was like, Cavalry Pegasus gives it flying anyway. But it's, yeah,
Cavalry Pegasus definitely gives it flying, but that
right.
is a lot.
All right, so that goes to the bottom.
Very good,
and we're done.
Home free.
So we're probably still gonna lose.
I don't know. We're making a good game out of it.
Oh, I agree.
We draw.
What do you think the odds are right now that we win? Like 50-50?
Not better.
Really?
I think we're pretty far ahead right now.
You're an optimist.
Yeah, everyone always tells me that.
Josh Ravitz, the optimist. So attack with both actually is frightening.
I guess he has a really good spell in his hand.
Faded Return, targeting Flesh Mad Steed.
That would do it. That would do it.
Grey Merchant, that's pretty good. It's a lot of damage.
Yeah, she's got a ton of issues now.
Should leave white blue upright, I think so. Yeah. Maybe should have white.
Or
Vanguard.
Or Vanguard, yeah.
But
okay.
I could draw Ordeal, so. I think I just attack with all of it.
Get
and
it
then I chomp here.
Chomp as soon as we can. So if he has a removal spell. It's just impossible. Yeah. Right? We can't.
I can't leave back two guys to chomp. And...
It's close. If he has another merchant or anything, maybe we should ship it.
Well, let me think.
Of course.
So, what are we hoping for? The thing is, the way our board is now, we don't really need, like, a Chosen by Heliod. Like, it'll be cool, but, what, like...
You're saying... Well...
We don't need to tap anything, really. So he's going to go to 9. He's going to attack. We chomp. We go to 7. We make another bird. And we can play the Sun Guide. I kind of want to keep it. And just hope that this stuff goes the distance.
Alright. Obviously that's bad? The hope. I mean, I don't know. It's so bad.
Like, my question is, what are we hoping to get to? Like, suppose you could tutor right now.
Tutor to the top right now? Not too sure. Might just be... So,
like, this
deal's not that great.
Yeah, our deal doesn't do much. Also, this works well with our mana. We can still make a bird and play this guy. I mean, like...
That's true.
Like, if we could tutor 100-handed one to the top or whatever, we would take it, and then we would cast it, because we know we're going to be able to cast it.
So it's, like, awkward if we draw... If the next card's 100-handed one, and we made a bird...
If the next card is any card that costs 4, although I don't think we have a lot.
We have that in the elk. And
yeah.
Something else, maybe. All right, let's keep it. You can win. Of course, he probably just has Sip discard two guys, kill us. But
well, that's fine. Yeah. I mean, it's not fine per se, but we, you know.
It's fine as it can be.
But also, next turn, we can chump with that guy and then have lethal following turn.
If we don't need to chump with the bird.
Yeah. Gonna chump, you agree?
I would chump really fast.
Yeah, okay.
It's a lot of damage.
Yeah. So, it's possible. Okay.
Are you jealous?
Well, I think he should have probably cast it pre-combat, right?
Yeah, you want to get more options.
Like, he might have wanted to attack that Omen Speaker. Griptide. No. Okay. Well,
fairly bad.
Yeah, so now... Now we just attack with both. Scry to the bottom. Play the Worshipper. And hope to just draw into... Chomp.
Yeah.
And then hope to draw anything that can do...
One damage.
I mean, there still is merit to leaving the guy on top.
Well, we have two ordeals to draw into...
The tour deals, yeah, that might be it though.
Can't think.
We have no bestow creatures, right?
Nothing we can do with. We have a 7 drop bestow, that's it.
Right.
What if we draw Acolyte's Ruler? Does that do anything?
No, we already cast it this game.
Okay, fine.
So, the question is if we scry to the bottom, right? We're basically conceding the game if we don't draw a creature and ordeal.
Mm-hmm.
Well, but we're winning the game on the spot, hopefully, if we draw ordeal, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, what's more likely? That we hit an ordeal on that exact card, or that the creature chumping buys us the extra turn?
I guess chumping is more likely to win.
All he needs is a 2-power creature.
Yeah.
The other option is...
We're kind of out of options. Yeah. Blocking with these creatures is horrible. We attack with just a skirmisher.
Doesn't do anything.
You like attack with just a 4/8.
I think we need to scry to the bottom and try to get lucky.
Yeah, we're pretty far behind here.
Yeah, because I think that the odds of him just playing a 2-power creature are too high.
Yeah. I'm inclined to scry to the bottom. I was. Surprise himself by doing something else. I just can't think of anything else.
No reason to play land, right? I have no cards that'll draw me two.
I don't think so. Does he know about it? This isn't the one I have to know. It's like very awkward that if we had both Lupe, it would be nice to go.
Yeah.
so we're sticking to our plan here?
I guess I have to, right? I lose to any creature.
You lose to... Yeah.
No, I just draw our deal, tap this, and I think we're actually at least made the correct play with the... Actually, just the creature.
If we draw a creature?
We draw a creature, and he can't do anything. We have two lethal, you know, we just block or whatever.
Dead everything, but also not.
Alright.
Okay, something.
Just attack the skirmisher, right?
Yeah, certainly. How often do you misclick your scry?
Pretty, I don't know if I've ever done it. You?
No.
Dead to a counter spell.
Oh, dead to literally everything. There's not a single card we're not dead to.
We're dead to...
Nausea.
Boon of Erebos.
Marsh Casualties.
We're dead to Grey Merchant.
Sip. Doesn't look like he has any of those. High Gouge. Viper's Kiss.
Could be Desperation.
Hopefully.
Is there any reason that I should block two? I guess Boon of Erebos. There's no reason not to block two, right? There's no edicts. There's like Shrikarpy, but who cares?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you agree, right?
I think we should double chop, yeah.
Yeah.
Should play around the one card that we can play around.
Yeah. If you can kill this, we're dead. Yeah. You just want to attack with this and it's over.
Extremely
good, yeah.
I mean. Can do our whole life here. Just grinding it out.
Just chomping every turn.
Just double chomp that turn. That felt... Oh, wow.
Bummer.
Alright, good game.
That's fine. I mean, it doesn't... doesn't matter. We can't block in a way where we can play around that. I think just run it back. Like, we took them to time there. Five cards,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, we almost had it.
I still don't want Stymied Hopes. Are
we good with one ray or two?
I think one ray. We only saw the one guy still.
Still.
Granted, we did chump it every turn for the whole game.
We could have two of them. Yeah, we did chump it every turn.
We could take Present Chimera out, but...
Would we want to?
I don't know. I'm just saying we could.
Obviously, we can't cut out this form since it's like our all-star cookie. All right. Let's run it again.
All right.
That was a close one.
Was. He must have drawn it there, right? He would have clearly killed that guy, like, in the past four turns or whatever.
He probably drew it, or I don't think he just, like, woke up in the middle of that combat set and he was like, oh, what am I doing?
Yeah, yeah. So, which probably means we were going to win if he didn't draw it. I mean, he probably had other outs, too.
He probably was drawing to, like, five cards.
Yeah, which is...
And he bounced spell.
And he divinationed in there, so...
He divinationed twice.
Well...
I mean...
Yeah, but he divinationed once since he clearly needed a way to deal with it. But yeah, we weren't in that great shape, obviously.
We were bleeding.
What did we draw after we scryed the guy to the bottom?
We drew, like, Pegasus, and then scryed away land, right?
Pegasus, yeah. I wonder if we had scryed that guy to the bottom the first time, although I think it was right to keep it.